In this video, we're going to learn how to make a new document in Adobe Fresco and correctly set the width and height and resolution. So I'm here in Fresco on the home screen. I'm going to tap the Create New button, and that's going to bring up a set of new document shortcuts. So this gives us links to save document templates, and you can see I've got a few different tabs here that will give me ones I've used recently, ones that I've saved, and some standard sizes for digital and print artwork. Let's go back to the Recent tab. So I could click any of those shortcuts and instantly get a new file. In this case, I want custom size so we can go through all of the settings. So when I click that custom size, you can see we get this new document dialog on the right-hand side of our shortcuts. And here, we want to make sure to name our new document. And as a rule, you want to be descriptive with your name. So don't just leave it on untitled. Don't call it something like my file. So I'll go ahead and give this a name. And next, we can move on to the units that we'll use to measure our file. So we have a drop down here where we can pick pixels, inches, centimeters, or millimeters. I'll go ahead and switch this to inches. And I can see here in the width and height boxes, I have 30 inches by 22.5 inches. So I can simply tap on either one of these to edit. In my case here, I want to make sure that I click this little lock icon. That's going to lock the width and height proportions together, so I'm going to get the same format no matter what size I change to. So let's go ahead and lock that, and we'll make this something a little bit smaller. Let's make it maybe 10 inches wide. That'll give us 7.5 inches height. We can also switch the orientation, so tapping either one of these buttons will just swap the width and height if we want a portrait or a landscape. In this case, I'll leave mine on landscape. Moving on down, we have this pixel size dialog, and this is where we set the resolution that we'd like our file to have. Depending on what units you have, this will either be listed as pixel size or print size, but it's basically controlling the same thing. If we're making a file that's only going to exist on screen, say something for a website, a resolution of 72 pixels per inch, or PPI, is going to be totally appropriate. So anything in the range of 72 up to about 150 going to work really well for things that only exist on screen. If we're working on a file that we'd like to print or have the option to print later on, we'd want a higher resolution, so something like at least 300. And that's what I'd like in this case. And I can see below my resolution setting, I'll get an output of the total pixel dimensions. And that's basically just multiplying the width by the PPI and the height by the PPI. Next, I have an option for what I'd like the background to look like. I could either have it white or transparent, where I'd see a grid of gray and white boxes. So that's purely a matter of preference. I'll just leave mine on white. And I have the option to save these settings as a shortcut template. So I can click that checkbox, and let's give this template a better name. And we can go ahead and click Create Document. So we're all set up here. Maybe let's go ahead and start to do some drawing. So with a pixel brush, I'm just going to go ahead and start drawing some shapes. And after doing some work on this file, I might get to a point where I'd like to change some aspect of the size, maybe the width, maybe the height, maybe the resolution, maybe all three. So for an existing file, we can go up to the settings icon that looks like a little gear, and we can click change next to the dimensions. So this brings back up our canvas size dialog, and we can make changes to the width and the height and the resolution. So when we make changes to an existing file, we need to think through and plan ahead for some potential pitfalls that might happen. So anytime we are decreasing a file, whether or not there's artwork in it, we can really do whatever we want. If we are increasing the size of a file, we need to pay attention to whether or not there's artwork in it. If there's any pixel-based artwork in the file, we want to make sure we only enlarge up to about 200% of the existing size, and that's going to help us avoid things like pixelation and distortion of the artwork. If we have a blank file, we can increase the scale or the resolution as much as we want. So since we've got some artwork here, let's do a little demo of how this would look, increasing maybe a little bit too much. So let's take this above 200%, which for the width would be something like 25, so that'd be 250%. So I'll click the lock to maintain my width and height proportions, and let's take this up to 25 inches. Go ahead and click OK. Now you can see what happens here. Fresco has enlarged the overall canvas, but it hasn't enlarged the artwork itself. So we get some options here in terms of what we want to do. Maybe we want to leave this the same scale and just add some extra space around it. In my case here, I want to expand it to fill the canvas. So I'll just tap and drag on these corner handles, and that's close enough. And I'll go ahead and click done. So let's zoom in a little bit on our artwork here. And we'll start to see some of the effects of increasing the scale a little bit more than we should. So I can see already I'm getting a little bit of pixelation. And if I compare this to drawing at the current scale, I can see this brushwork that we made after the enlargement looks nice and smooth. This brushwork that we've enlarged is a little bit pixelated. So we just want to be careful in terms of how much we might scale up an existing document. All right, that's how to make a new document and adjust the width, height, and resolution in Adobe Fresco.